Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here, and welcome to a very special bonus part of Let's Play Banjo-Tooie, where I'll be tackling some endgame things a lot of you have been requesting. And first and foremost, I decided to start things off in the Jinjo Village and actually talk to Jingling, because we really never got to talk to him after the party. And now that we restored his life and his castle is gold again, I think it's a safe time to approach him and see how things are in the Jinjo Village. And I still don't know what kind of pet that thing is. I really want to know, but anyway, let's talk to him. Welcome back. Are you feeling better now, Mr. Ringling? Couldn't be better. Thanks. Hey, that Ms. B is a wizard cook. Those scones at the party were top-notch. We wouldn't know you, and Greedy Klungo ate them all before we even got there. Sorry. Well, let's see what more you have to say. It's all quiet in Jinjo Village. I think we can go home. Yeah, King Sing-Along. Unless your people need saving for a third time. Sing-Along, Ring-A-Ling, Ding-A-Ling. Come on, guys, please remember my name. I'm the one and only King Jingling. Well, we mispronounced his name enough times, so I think we should leave now. So anyway, yeah, that's a nice little funny dialogue that you can access after the game's over. And now that we've done that, let's actually head out this way toward the Wooded Hollow, where we're taking on Master Jiggy Wiggy's final puzzle challenge, which is kind of like the same thing as Banjo-Kazooie the Bottles Challenge. So we'll be seeing that. And I just wanted to stop by and see the white Jinjo house. I don't know, we get to see the happy Jinjo theme when you collect all the Jinjos. But I just feel bad for the white Jinjo family. It's just one of them. I mean, he's the last of his kind. Like, I'm surprised he's not, like, hateful of the world and other Jinjos and jealous of them. I mean, I'm expecting, like, a sequel to be, like, White Dead Redemption instead of Red Dead Redemption, that white Jinjo. I want to see that. Someone make a box cover of the white Jinjo in Red Dead Redemption form. That'd be amazing if you could play as a whole game as a white Jinjo in that. Someone mod that. But anyway, with that silliness aside, let's head out to the temple and take on Master Jiggy Wiggy's final puzzle challenge. And if you remember in the last game, I couldn't finish out Bottles challenges. The last one was way too hard and involves the same kind of puzzle here, so let's see how I fare this time. Maybe it's a little easier, maybe it's a little harder. So here we go, the super special challenge, special rules. Basically, we can now rotate the puzzle pieces and we have to put them all in this time. So this is actually very hard, but a good piece of strategy right here is just to match up the picture that you're seeing right now to like what Banjo's doing like right there, and you just match it up with the puzzle piece because it's all animated. So that actually makes it a much easier process, and yeah, and this one I practiced a couple times. I didn't fail once, so I didn't really have any trouble, so if you just match it with the animations in the background, you shouldn't have too much trouble, right? So anyway, while I'm doing this, and it's kind of boring, yeah, it's actually Valentine's Day right now, so happy Valentine's Day, everyone. I know I'm spending it right now talking to myself in front of a computer monitor with a sock over my mic right now. Yeah, I'm actually using a sock as a, like a boom thing because it limits like the sound of your audio. So I'm trying that. So it looks kind of, my setup looks kind of ridiculous right now, and they're probably laughable to show it off. But alas, I can't because I don't have the equipment to do so. I've always wanted to make a little tutorial on how to record Let's Plays. A lot of people have been asking me. I actually made one like 4 years ago, but that's so outdated. I actually got rid of it. This was a very, very bad video. But yeah, if I had a camera or a webcam, I would definitely do that. And, yeah, if I had a webcam as well, I would do, like, that actually wouldn't limit my ability to stream, but I always wanted to do, like, those kind of streams where you show, like, yourself in the corner and whatnot. That actually looks pretty cool, but nonetheless, we finished this in 80 seconds with 20 to spare, and now that I declare that the new fastest time of 80, surpassing the old record of 87, that was the one I had in the practice run, so I even got a better score that time. Awesome. I wonder what, like, the record is, like, the world record. But yeah, behind Jiggy Wiggy, hey, you can go right through that cheat, and we have 3 signs right here. Basically, these signs have somewhat of an importance. Have you looked on the roof of the Red Jinjo House? I think that had like a treble clef on it, so we already got that. Which you rolled is where fortune may smile upon you. Yeah, I'll be explaining that. An egg container followed by jingling. That is a riddle right there. Basically, I'm gonna flash a couple cheats on board that we didn't do in the game. These are official cheats. If you type in Cheeto get Jiggy, you basically can get tips on where every Jiggy is in the game in Jiggy Wiggy's Temple, and if you type in Cheeto nest egg, you get unlimited eggs and whatnot. So, unlimited eggs and feathers, I believe, and it says lots. So yeah, if you just go in Jiggy Wiggy's, not Jiggy Wiggy's Temple, the cheat room, you can do that. Alright, so now that we fast forward, we're actually in Jolly's, and we're gonna dance along right now to the jukebox that we got by getting the last of final cheats in the game, or Cheeto pages. And let's see, what tracks do we want to play right here? We got Spiral Mountain, but it's so sad because they have the sad version of Spiral Mountain. I want to hear, like, the old Banjo-Kazooie tunes. They kind of got the depressed Spiral Mountain there. It's not so much fun to dance to. Let's see, Miscellaneous. What we got? Banjo's theme is the title theme. Yeah, if you just hear it right there. Now let's see, Waiting Boots, Springy Step Boots. What's something new? Oh, here comes Trouble. Oh god, yeah, I have this dark music playing out of the jukebox. Hey, freaking Jolly's even danced to it. That's very scary, actually. That makes it that much more creepier. Let's see, Isle of Hags, what do you got? It actually has all the remixes for Outside of the Worlds. Jinjo Village, Sad Jinjo House, Happy Jinjo House, that's the one we just listened to. And what else do we have here? The zombie one, but yeah, the Party at Bottles, basically, yeah, if you want even, like, I don't know, like, why you would even want to unlock the jukebox, I mean, you have YouTube for that now, you can just listen to them online, but if you just want to go back here and play some songs from the game, then have a hoot, have a blast. But I'm gonna end on Roll the Credits because there's one thing I have yet to show off, that is the Character Parade. If you collect all the jikis in the game, you unlock it. You can only access it through the menu for some reason in the Xbox Live version. I might be in the N64 version normally. So without further ado, let's head on to the title and watch the parade. Alright, so we're here at the title. I just want to show you how to do it because a lot of people probably would be asking me, oh, how do you get the Character Parade? Because I didn't even think it was in the game. That's why I said in the last finale part, I was expecting a Character Parade, but here it is. Just click on it and we'll get that parade after all. Alright, so yeah, I was expecting this to be along with the credits. I don't know why you have to access it, but if you collected all 90 jiggies, here you go. You've been watching the Golden Goliath, our first little mumbo thing right there. Very cool. So we get to reminisce about the game and whatnot. I've already said all my thank yous, and once again, I just want to just reiterate, thank you guys so much for watching. You guys made this playthrough such a blast, and you guys really make me want to make more videos, and you've been so supportive, and whatnot. What more can I say? Again, I want to thank the creators of the game. We made a hell of a series. Still waiting on Banjo 3. Hopefully you guys can get together. I know the old Rare team wants to make a new one, so maybe we'll get a game similar to that. I know Hat in Time's coming out soon. That is actually a spiritual successor to Banjo-Kazooie. Like, not, it's not the same game. I mean, it's takes the ideas from that game and does it. So when that game comes out, I definitely want to play it, and maybe I'll even let's play it too. Because it fits that much like of an inspiration from Banjo-Kazooie, I definitely have to play it one and two. I might have to let's play it because it might be a great game. It already has a lot of support from a lot of people in the gaming community and YouTube community, so definitely have to give it a go. I already bought it, actually. I did the Kickstarter. Oh, Canary Mary. You're one of the faces I didn't want to see in the Character Parade. So yeah, since I already gotten all those things out in the last credit roll, I'm just going to... I love old King Hole's hands right here. He's like, I'm gonna get you. Or he's like, I'm just stretching out my fingers right here. Don't mind me. And I love how Konga got a new job after that job throwing oranges off a palm tree was too taxing. He took up a job as a freaking lion tamer or something. And I don't want to see that when I order my food. Now it makes me like second guess when I go to like a fast food place and order something. I think those guys are at least Salty Joe's freaking sanitary. Oh, okay, ew, okay, he's got boogers, that's disgusting. I thought you were clean, Salty Joe. Hey, the Sorcerer of Peril, that was my favorite minigame, actually, so it's nice to see you. So yeah, I'm just doing a little nonchalant little riff right here of all the things we've seen in the game, since I've already seen all my thank yous and whatnot, I've said all my thank yous. So, Mr. Patch, very annoying boss fight, very disorienting, I had to fly through him. Hey, Jolly Roger, you're still... a weird stereotype I can't even, like, put my finger on. Don't know what they were trying to go for there. Obviously, they were going for something. Mary Maggie Malpass. Okay, that's a very long name. What the hell's a Malpass? Must be a British thing. Pawno. Reminds me of that show Pawn Stars, and he just sounds so miserable. I feel so bad for him. He's got a freaking sack of gold back there. I think he'd be happier. Tip-Top and Tip-Top Jr. Aw, look at the little baby Tip-Top. I wonder if they'll ever make a new, like, Diddy Kong Racing. Because that's the thing, oh, this guy, that's actually pretty handy, no pun intended, that he can grab the beach ball and wave to us at the same time. But I wonder if they'll ever make, like, another Diddy Kong Racing, because that's weird, because Mario Kart and Captain Black Eye, of course, I had a dream once, you know that. But yeah, Diddy Kong Racing, they made, like, 8 or 9 Mario Karts, why not make, like, a Diddy Kong Racing series? I never understood that. Microsoft has so much, like, I don't get it, man, they have so much... I don't know if they have the Diddy Kong Racing license, actually, because that's Donkey Kong. Donkey Kong is still owned by Nintendo. So I don't think they actually have access to that, so I'm not even gonna, like, go into that. But if they did, they could have freaking, like, they have so much in their, like, back pockets, Microsoft, and there's just so much wasted potential with Rare property and stuff. I know they just made a new Killer Instinct game, I think that's called. I never really got into that. I love how we define these characters by, oh, he's holding a wrench, one's holding a laser gun. They're both the same, okay. And of course, Crispy Bacon, one of my favorite characters, best names in the game. But yeah, they just, Microsoft has so much of Rare's intellectual property that they can make, like, if they made a Banjo 3, you know how much that, like, I don't understand, like, no one at Microsoft's gonna go up to them and be like, hey, we have this game that everyone's been requesting, and we're probably gonna sell, like, I don't know, 10 million copies of it. That's probably an exaggeration, but still, more than Nuts and Bolts, and Nuts and Bolts even sold well. It was actually a pretty good game, even though it wasn't from the original. It should have been a different game, but that's besides the point. But I don't get it. They can make so much money, and it's just such a... If I worked at Microsoft or Rare, that would be my first. I want to buy Microsoft to make Banjo 3. That's like my dream. Really, or just revive Rare. That's really the big dream, and make Banjo 3. That's what I would do if I had a million or billion dollars. First order of business. Don't solve world hunger. Don't cure cancer. Make Banjo 3. That's the way. Alright, so let's get back into what we're looking at here. Yeah, we got the dinosaurs we rescued. The help of Mumbo. That was actually a very interesting... That's the thing with this game, is that it was a very big overworld, and you can actually, like, traverse around, like, different areas. That's why I like Banjo-Kazooie better. It's, like, in a lair, it's all nice and put together, kind of like Super Mario 64. That's the one reason I don't like Banjo-Tooie, is being way too ambitious. And it's a way funnier game, obviously. They add a lot more dialogue and a lot more jokes, but I just liked how close together Banjo-Kazooie was. It felt like you were on an adventure. You were in a lair, like, Grunty would always chime in making jokes. I like the whole, puzzle piece thing. I don't like the whole Jiggy Wiggy in this game, not really my thing. It's just Banjo-Kazooie, I think it's just an all-around better game. Tooie is a really, really good game in its own right, but Banjo-Kazooie just had a certain charm and a certain thing about it that Tooie couldn't quite capture and try to make its own thing, which I respect. And Lago, I just love seeing the old characters from the old games. But, yeah, it just couldn't... I'm not gonna say it couldn't pull it off, but I just... It turned me off. Like, when I go back and play, like, these two games, and Walder, one of the best creatures, I think coolest designs in this game. But when I go back and play, like, Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie, I'd rather play Banjo-Kazooie. It's way more fun, in my opinion. Banjo-Tooie just... It seems like a chore half the time. There's a lot of collectibles, a lot of traversing throughout the world. You have to go back to one to learn a move, and And Saberman. I actually learned that Rare, that was one of the earlier games that they designed. Saberman and the Wolves, or something like that. See, that's why I think Kazooie is a way better game, and even though Tooie is a great game in its own right, it's a good game. It's just not one of my favorites. Certainly when compared to Banjo-Kazooie. Let's see here. We got the child names. They're actually, like, the same names as the adult aliens, but added, like, at the end, so very creative right there. Hey, it's Boggy. Whoa-hey! That's my best impression, but he's still getting fatter. And, of course, Mrs. Boggy. This had to make the twins right there and make those jiggle physics, did they? But funny nonetheless. And of course the kid's Groggy. That bedspread right there. If I was like 8 years old, I would have wanted that. That looks awesome right there. They didn't really make a lot of Banjo-Kazooie merchandise, I've realized. Like, they didn't really sell any plushies. I don't collect plushies, by the way. Just making a reference. Or making an example. But Banjo-Kazooie really wasn't one of those commercially, like, successful, like, merchandising kind of things. Like, you had Crash Bandicoot, you had, like, all the popular guys like Sonic. Oh, obviously he wasn't a mascot character, Banjo, but still, you would think that would be a little more marketable, they could have sold a little more things, because Nintendo just kept Banjo in their back pocket for all that time, and I don't know, they could have used him for a lot more things, and they could have definitely made a lot more money, because he's one of the underrated characters throughout video games, and he just doesn't get the respect that series deserved. I mean, it's just really sad, it's just missed potential, that's just the thing. And we got the Dragon Brothers, Double Dragons, not Bimmy and Jimmy, but Chilly Willy and Chilly Willy, or Chilly Billy. I'm gonna put an RIP next to him and Mildred. That's just... I think I passed Mildred too, that's the thing too. Say two again, okay. But yeah, it's very sad right there. 1984, that's what it spells out. Again, another important year for Rare. And we got Guffo and Jolly's Juice. Ugh. Snacky Fatty Chucks. Definitely gonna eat some Snacky Fatty Chucks today with my Valentine's Day candy. Know what I'm saying? Mr. Fit. Definitely motivated me to get back into the gym. I've been getting back into the gym the last 2 months now. I've been really trying to get a little routine going. Because I always used to work out and, getting a routine down, just eating right, it's just the way to go, you know? Yeah, we passed Minji Jongo. Definitely one of the scarier villains in this game. Totally didn't see it coming when I first played, and we got the Jiggy Wiggies right here, the Disciple and Master. This Disciple, I don't know, just the weird design of the Jiggy Wiggy family. I mean, their heads are Jiggy, so you would think that, I guess they are an endangered species because people would harvest them to make Jiggies, like, we're collecting their heads. I mean, it's kind of gruesome when you think about it, and Honeybee and Haggy. Honeybee was actually pretty helpful, we got those empty honeycombs. But in the last game, we can just do it automatically, so she was kind of unnecessary, wasn't she? And of course, Cheeto. I don't get why he's so sad. Like, we collected all your Cheeto pages, man. What more do you want? I mean, the lair's destroyed, but you can move out of there, you know? You don't have to live there. Dingpot, the silent hero of the two games, definitely helped us out. Wouldn't have beaten the game without him. Goggles playing with his little DK toy. You got Specky with his Ash Ketchum hat and a plane from, I guess, another game. Maybe it's just the plane, I don't know. They always make references, so I wouldn't be surprised. Maybe Jeff Force Gemini. And Miss Bottle with her Banjo-Tooie mug. I just love her hair curls, by the way, too. I think I've already pointed that out. And Bottle said, oh my god, no! They killed him! I was just joking. They actually killed him? Oh my god! The humanity! The fishality! That's terrible. Like, we rescued the guy under a boulder. Okay, no. First game, he was fried. That second game, he was under a boulder. We saved his life. He helped us and gave us extra bubbles. We put him back into the lake. Everything was fine. Oh, I think his name was Toots. But yeah, they just kill him. They roast him up and eat him. That's, it's terrible. Aw, oh, Royce, did I? He had such a bad rap in this game. Oh, man. What a terrible shake. But, anyway, we're coming toward the end of this character parade. We got Humbawumba, I'm guessing Mumbo, then the two heroes, and that's about it. And oh no, we got Bob Elda and the witchies and whatnot. So yeah, I'm just gonna wrap it up right here. Yeah, basically, once again, thank you guys for watching. This was a great and fun Let's Play, one of my favorites, and really love the feedback on it. And we'll be starting our, not our next Let's Play, our new Let's Play, but we'll be continuing Kingdom Hearts 2, basically. That was a game that I started in February. I went on hiatus in October. I'm planning to bring it back this month and finish that up, then getting back to my older LPs and maybe starting a new one alongside of that just to make everything fresh and whatnot. And that is the plan. And of course, Banjo and our final hero of the game, Kazooie, who really is the main hero of Banjo-Kazooie. She does absolutely everything and she deserves the credit, so... Yep, that's about it. Thank you guys again for watching, and I will see you on my next Let's Play, and let's just see the final time that we got. I used every save file here, so it's kind of confusing to tell. 14 hours, 34 minutes. That's a long time, but we did it. See you next time.